morning students. In the previous class we have seen what is meant by a work done, what is amount of differential work done, and we have calculated some numericals under differential amount of work done. Now in this class we'll see what is meant by a potential. Potential is nothing but moving an object from one place to another place. For example, if I wanted to move a chair from one point to other point, I have to give some force towards it. That is called as my potential. So potential is nothing but moving an object from one point to other point. What is meant by a potential difference? Potential difference is nothing but it is a difference between any two points within the electric field is defined as the work done in moving a unit positive discharge from one point to another point. It is called as your potential. Absolute potential means moving a charge from one point to other point in the presence of electric field is called as a potential. Absolute potential means moving the charge in the presence of electric field from infinity to the point under consideration is nothing but your absolute potential. Potential means moving a charge from one point to other point in the presence of electric field. Absolute potential means moving a charge from infinity to the point under consideration in the presence of electric field is called as your absolute potential. Now we know that the absolute work done on a unit charge is going to be your potential dV. That we can write it as minus E dot dl. If a unit charge is going to be moved from point B to point A in the presence of this electric field, then we can write the potential difference as dW by Q is nothing but your dV, which is equal to minus E dot dl. In case if I wanted to identify V, means V is equal to minus integration between lower limit and upper limit. The differential amount of work done per unit charge will give the potential, which is equal to minus E dot dl. So if you wanted to identify the potential V, we have to integrate towards this side from your initial point to the final point. For example, if you are moving the test charge from point B to point A, then we can write it as VAB is equal to minus B to A E dot dl. From point B to point A, if you are moving, then here B will become VAB, we have to write it. So from this, in general, we can write it as V is equal to minus integration over the closed line E dot dl volts. So case 2, suppose in a closed loop, in the sense, for example, you are moving a charge from point B to point A, again from point A to point B, it is nothing but your closed loop. So if you are doing like that, the limit will become B to B, and hence in any closed path the potential is equal to 0. It is just like a short circuited path in the circuit. So we can write it as V is equal to integration over the closed line E dot dl is equal to 0. So this field satisfies the equation known as law of conservation of field. So law of conservation of field is nothing but charges can neither be created nor be destroyed. So this will relate to your conservative field. This equation is nothing but your Maxwell's second equation in integral form. What is your Maxwell's first equation? Maxwell's first equation in electrostatics is divergence dot D is equal to rho V. That is the mean differential form. In integral form, integration over the closed surface D dot ds is equal to Q. Like you have to write the Gauss's law in integral form and point form. That is your Maxwell's first equation in electrostatics. Maxwell's second equation is integral over the closed line E dot dl is equal to 0. In any closed circuit, the potential is equal to 0. That definition is stated as Maxwell's second equation in integral form under static electric field. So we have two types of field. One is your static field, another one is your dynamic field. Static field means your field remains same. Dynamic field means from time to time your field is getting changed. So Maxwell's first equation in point form is divergence dot D is equal to rho V. Maxwell's first equation in integral form is integral over the closed surface D dot ds is equal to Q. It is your Maxwell's first equation in point form, Maxwell's first equation in integral form. So Gauss's divergence theorem. Gauss's divergence theorem means we know that according to Gauss's law, the electric flux density coming out from any closed surface is equal to the charge enclosed. Suppose if the charge enclosed is of volume charge density, then we can write it as rho v is equal to q divided by v. dq is equal to integral over the volume of surface rho v dot dv. So here we will get integral over the closed surface rho v dot dv. Rho v is nothing but divergence dot d. That we can simply write it as divergence dot d into dv. Based on this one problem we will solve. Given the electric field E is equal to 40xy ax plus 20x square ay plus 2az all per meter. Calculate the potential between the point. So between these two points we need to identify the potential. We know that potential dv is equal to minus e dot dl. Dl is equal to dl into al. We can write this dl as dx ax plus dy ay plus dz az. So dv is equal to minus, in the place of e you have to substitute 40xy ax plus 20x square ay plus 2az into, in the place of dl we can substitute dx ax plus dy ay plus dz az. Between these two points, I need to identify the potential between the point 1 comma minus 1 comma 0 and q comma 2, q of 2 comma 1 comma 1. So using slope equation, y2 minus y1 divided by a straight line equation, straight line equation, y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1 is equal to y minus y1 divided by x minus x1. So I can write it as, solving between these two points, we will get y is equal to 2x minus 3. When you find dy over here, you will get dy is equal to 2 into dx. Substituting y is equal to 2x minus 3 in this particular equation, you will get dv is equal to 40. In the place wherever you have y, you replace it with 2x minus 3 and you will get one equation, 120x square. You will get this wherever you have y, you replace it with 2x minus 3. After replacing, you will get dv is equal to minus 120x square minus 120x into dx plus 2dz. So between these two points, between the point P and Q, I need to identify a potential between these two points. So it can be identified as Q to P. Your x limit is from this point. X limit is from 2 to 1. Y limit is from 1 to minus 1. Z limit is from 3 to 0. So you find the potential by taking integration towards this side. X limit is from 2 to 1 and Z limit is from 3 to 0. Here Y term is absent, so you can substitute the limits only for X and Z. So after solving, you will get VPQ is equal to 106 volts. It is the expression for, it is your potential between the point P to Q. Now we'll identify the potential difference and absolute potential expression due to the point charge of Q coulombs. Now you consider here one charge is available. Based on the charge, if it is going to be a positive charge, the fields are outwards. If it is going to be a negative charge, the fields are inwards. Now consider point A, B. The point A is placed at a distance of r meter from point O. And point B is placed at a distance of r2 meter from point O. Now this is the point where exactly we need to identify the potential or potential difference. So we need to write, whenever a charge is present over here, when you are moving a charge against your test charge, then in the presence of your electric field, it is going to be your potential. So E is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon r square. This we all know very well from your module 1. If a unit positive test charge is moved with the direction of dl in radial direction, the change in potential is given as dv is equal to dw divided by qt, which is equal to minus e dot dl. So dv is equal to minus q divided by 4 pi epsilon r square. In the place of e, you have to substitute with the original equation ar. So the direction of the unit vector for this electric field intensity is towards your r direction, so ar vector. Dl is equal to dr dot ar. Dot product of ar dot ar will be equal to 1. So we can write dv is equal to minus q divided by 4 pi epsilon r square into dr vector. Now to identify your v, I need to integrate on your right hand side with respect to r. So the distance from where to where it is going to move. So you are going to move the charge from point B to A or point A to B. If you are moving the charge from point B to A, you have to write it as VBA. Suppose if you are moving the charge from point A to B, you can write it as VAB, which is equal to point B to A means we need to write it as VAB. Point A to B means we have to write it as VBA. Integration B to A equal into dV, which is equal to integration between the line AB to A Q divided by 4 pi r square into dr vector. Here r limits from r1 to what is the distance given r2. From B to A we are going to move, right? So from r2 to r1. So if you integrate in the place of B r2, in the place of A r1 if you put, you will get VAB is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon minus 1 by R2 plus 1 divided by R1. So we can write it as VAB is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. It is the potential difference when you are moving a charge from point B to point A. In case if you want to identify the absolute potential, the definition for absolute potential is moving a charge from infinity to point under consideration, moving the unit positive charge from infinity to the point under consideration. So here we can make this R2 to be infinity. So when you make R2 to be infinity, you will get Q divided by 4 pi epsilon into R1 or Q divided by 4 pi epsilon into Rf. The general expression for your potential or absolute potential is V is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon into R. So in the next class, we'll solve some numericals using this potential, absolute potential.